So welcome back students. So today I will discuss the remaining part of this unit, that is interactions between the biotic and the abiotic factors. So basically interactions means relationship between biotic and abiotic, means biotic and the abiotic factors are the complementary to each other. Suppose to have, if you have the green plants, and these green plants are called the producers. So they are produce foods, okay, so synthesize the foods and the oxygen. Suppose to have the the carbon dioxide and the light is not there, so how do they prepare their food and oxygen? It is possible? No. Okay, so that means if the abiotic component is not there, that times the food will not prepare. So the abiotic factors having some definite contributions. So there is a good relationship between each other. Means in case of abiotic factors like the temperatures, like the soil, some of the other gases are very important, very essentials. Suppose in a hot and very wet climate will support the presence of evergreen trees. Okay, evergreen trees. Some other animals will require this kind of environment, like hot and climate, wet climates is required. Until and unless it's not there, they are not survive. So how the ecosystem will maintain? How they are balance their environment? Is it not? It is not possible. So that means this kind of weather is also needed. So varieties of this thing, abiotic component, is required for various kind of organisms, or you can say that the animals, plants. Okay, so in case of cold climate, so if the temperature and that particular area is too much high, so that means there the survival, there the animals, that area's animals will not survive, because they are not habituated that too much hot weather. So they are only habituated in the cold weather. If the weather is not too much cold or cold, for that time that particular area's animal will not survive. Why? Because they are not habituated. Their ecosystem is something different. Our ecosystem is something different. So various kind of places having the various kind of ecosystems. So different kinds of ecosystem is required for different kinds of organisms. Okay, so that means the biotic and the abiotic factors are correlated to each other. Okay, so today I will discuss the unit 2, that is the food chains and the energy transfer. So this is the very important topic, food chains and the energy transfer. So basically the food chain, that means from the name food chains, you have understood what I want to tell. So that means food chain means, that means the relationship between the plants and the animals. In other words, we can say that the relationship between the plants and the animals, okay, or you can say that how the food is being connected to plants and the animals, or you can say that the other definition, the transfer of energy from the plant to the animals, or number of not plant to the animals, or you can say that the other consumers, it may be herbivores, it may be the carnivores. Okay, so that means food chains means you can say that the relationship, food relationship, food chain is related with the foods. So that means the food relationship between the plants and the animals. So this is basically called the food chains, or the energy transfer from the plants to the animals or other consumers like herbivores and the carnivores. Okay, so now coming to the point, this simple food chain in the grassland. So see students, so this sun has been required, so this is the abiotic component is required for this producer grass. So grass is required this abiotic component, and after that produce this grass, and grass is taking this herbivores, or you can say that the herbivores, or simply you can say that herbivores are the plant eaters. Okay, they are the primary consumers. Okay, so these are the primary consumers. They are taking this grass, and after that this lion has take this deer. So this is the relationship, food relationship, from plant to the animals. So some of the examples of the food chains are given below. Like the plants directly eats, human beings are directly eats the plants, as well as the grass, like the deer, rabbit and sheep has taking this grass, and after that this lion has taken this rabbit, deer or the sheep. So this is the food chain from the plant to the animal, or you can say that the energy transfer from grass to the lion. So like the grass, insects and bat, we can say that insects are taking this grass, and bats are taking this insects. So these are the relationship. So this food relationship basically called the food chain. Okay, like some of the other example is there, some of the food chain diagram is also there. Okay, some suppose that some of the insects take these grasses, and the frog has taken this insect, and after the snake has take this frog, and the hawk or this is take by this snake also. Means the main thing is producer to the consumer food relationship, basically called the food chain. Okay, so in the next video I will discuss the food web and the other remaining part. Thank you.